If we learned anything over the last 6 months, it's that we should be more than willing to give good CEOs the benefit of the doubt when they're honest with us. Last December, Conagra, the packaged food company, its mine Chef Boyardee, Hebrew National, Orville Redenbacher, Bertolli, Pam, Slim Jims, and many other brands reported a strong quarter. But CEO Sean Connolly also told us that his recent acquisition of Pinnacle Foods had some unanticipated issues, so it might take him longer to hit his synergy targets. In response, the stock got obliterated and quickly fell from 30 to 20 bucks in a matter of weeks. The thing is, if you sold Conagra down there, you got to be kicking yourself, as the company reported an excellent quarter last month, and they told us the integration of Pinnacle Foods is already back on track. Plus, Wall Street is warm to the food industry again. And last week, Conagra told a very bullish story at its annual analyst day. It was a very big analyst day, probably the biggest I've seen other than Disney. No wonder the stock has surged back to 30 bucks, giving you a nearly 50% gain from its lows. So could this thing have more room to run? Let's check in with Sean Connolly. He's the straight-shooting president and CEO of Conagra Brands. Get a better read on how his company's doing. It's headed, Mr. Connolly. Welcome back to Mad Money.
Jim.
Good to see you.
Glad to be here, Sean.
Great that you're here. All right, so first, because your analyst meeting was so important and set the tone, I'm going to ask you what you said you put to everybody. Why are you more excited about Conagra than ever?
Because we got a great portfolio, we've got the right people, the right culture, the right processes, and importantly, the right capabilities to continue growth and continue expanding our margins. We have built significant innovation capability over the last 4 years. You can see a lot of it here, and it's really exciting.
And the problems with Pinnacle behind?
Well, they're executional in nature.
You know, you
folks weren't accustomed to Pinnacle running into challenges, but no brand is exempt from challenges. You have to innovate every single year and execute every single year. These were executional challenges. I said from the beginning that we could deal with them. We had the capabilities to do it. And we introduced a deluge of innovation on the Pinnacle brands the other day, and I think we got a positive feedback from our investors.
I know that there's a ton of things here, but you've got three key brands. I think it's really interesting. This is Bird's Eye, which we all use.
Yep.
I thought this was interesting. Chips Ahoy's not your brand, but you've decided to do something with them for Duncan Hines, turn that around.
Yep.
And so it seems like it's in motion.
Yeah, Pinnacle's challenges really have been largely confined to three big businesses, the ones you point out. The biggest of all is Bird's Eye. Bird's Eye is a juggernaut. It's got twice the market share of the next closest competitor, but it really needed to ramp up innovation. And we've got meaningful innovation coming out, including innovation based on Conagra legacy capabilities that the Pinnacle team previously didn't have access to. So we're excited to bring those to our customers, and we're sharing that right now.
I've got a lot of stuff from the analyst meeting, but one of the greatest lines was when you guys were talking about the notion, and this is slighting my own cohort, that look at our stuff. And here it is. It's just so funny. I love it. It says, ask yourself, do you still think this is a boomer brand? You literally said, listen, we're not the baby boomer brand that you think we are.
Well, brands are evergreen, but only if you infuse them with modern attributes.
Right.
And so for the last 4 years, we've taken a large, vast portfolio, and we've modernized it across the board. And our focus is making sure these brands resonate with young consumers, millennials. Everything you see here fits what millennials are looking for.
They like bowls.
They like bowls, they like plant-based nutrition. One of the great things about the Pinnacle portfolio is access to Bird's Eye and Gardein. These millennials are not just vegetarians and vegans, they're increasingly flexitarians. And now we've got some of these flexitarian assets to bring to them. Plant-based is a big movement, Jim.
In the meantime, this is just a great category for you.
Great acquisition. That Angie's Boom Chicka Pop has been a home run for us. It is the fastest growing ready-to-eat popcorn out there. It's a great category overall. And we've done similar things in meat snacks with Duke's, where we already had a juggernaut in Slim Jim, but Duke's gives us a more curated premium offering, and it's really been a home run.
One of the things that you teach in your analyst day, and there's a lot of teaching, which I love, you talk about the Conagra way, but you also talk about the old way of you put TV, you do even some bus. What did you say? There's even, you put them in bus.
Bus shelters.
Yeah. You said that's how it used to be done.
Everything that I learned when I started out is basically obsolete now.
But isn't that, how are you able to switch? Most people can't switch.
You got to be a lifelong learner. And for us, it's very pragmatic. We're ROI focused. You know, we got to deliver a profit. So if we spend money to build a relationship between our consumer and our brands, and it doesn't work, we're the first ones to pull that money and try something new. So, two-thirds of what we do now marketing-wise is really digital, social. It's personalizing our content, especially for these younger consumers. And you know what? It's working.
I think you need to tell, again, the younger consumers, it got lost in the whole Pinnacle thing, why they like the frozen food aisle so much.
Well, they like three things that we're doing. Frozen, they love condiments because they love bold flavor, and they love snacking. And frozen, condiments, and snacking are three of our priorities. I think frozen is the perfect food form for today's consumers, especially millennials, because it's super convenient. They have no culinary skills, and they're the first generation to be making less money than their parents.
Skills.
They really don't. And
I never thought of that.
But they love good food. And, right. and one millennial told us, when I get home at 9 o'clock at night, I'm tired, but my taste buds are not. And they're used to having eaten out at restaurants when they grew up. They don't want to eat lousy food. They want to eat great food. And one of the things we're doing is making the food great again. Because for years, the industry kind of got away from great food, and I think
yes.
you see that changing.
But I think that also your packaging, I mean, there was an old way for wishbone, and it looked like our grandparents' wishbone. It does matter, right?
Well, wishbone's an interesting one because that's one of the businesses that struggled after we made the
right.
acquisition. And
right.
when people shop salad dressing, what they're looking for is variety. And there was an issue with the label change that the team had made. The variety was hidden. That's an easy fix. We can get those back into the marketplace pretty quickly.
No, I was going over these with my wife. I wasn't telling her which ones were you. I named some of the old ones. And then I said, Frontera, Boom Chicka Pop, Biggs, Deuce. And she said, well, those are all good brands. That must be a different company. I mean, you have to work to try to make it so. I know you love the older brand. Legacy did well.
Well, we like incrementality. So when we take a legacy iconic brand like Healthy Choice and we modernize it, we get big time velocities, turns off the store shelf. But when we can add a new modern brand to that, like an Angie's Boom Chicka Pop, we might be able to access some incremental consumers. You put it together, you end up with a higher overall household penetration than you would have had if you just chose one strategy versus the other.
How much promotion are you doing in store?
Well, we do a tremendous amount of partnering with our customers right
okay.
now, and it's getting access to their data so we can tailor our content
right,
to consumers.
Right.
It's sampling in store because these products are really great to eat. It's things like getting merchandising at the end of an aisle when an item is new on shelf so consumers can find it.
Right, because these are always, I see these and I always
pick
them up.
Those are brand new, absolutely.
I always pick them up. Well, I want to thank Sean Connolly, Conagra Brands President and CEO. You had to have faith in him because look what's been accomplished. And are these not things that maybe my generation isn't eating, but we don't want my generation anymore. We want the people of lifelong, and when you're 20s and 30s, and they'll stick with
Absolutely.
You. All right, Sean, thank you so much. Mad Money's back after the break. Booyah! Jim Cramer here from Mad Money. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube. Click here to subscribe and get the jump on my exclusives with CEOs, plus market news, investing advice, and a whole lot more.